So, hi there. Today we're going to be doing a book unhaul, and the same thing as with the book haul, I'm just going to be showing you the books that I've either not going to read or read that I'm currently trying to sell, just to get a bit of money, or if I can't sell them, then they'll be donated. Let's get into it. I'm trying to do very, very short videos on Instagram and TikTok. So I'll put the link in the description or the username and you can follow that. So I have literally a bag of books that I'm going to be letting go of. And the first one is Dark Tides by Philippa Gregory. And I didn't realise this was the second book in a duology or a series. I think it's like two books. And I didn't realise until I bought it, and then I was like, sugar. So I haven't read it, but I'm letting it go because I don't have any interest in it anymore. And I didn't return it to the shop because I bought it from a charity shop. So I didn't want to, you know, take it back for that reason because it was kind of cheap anyway. Has this kind of has this map inside. You've got the river, St. George Fields, and you've got these really cute embossery kind of stuff. So yeah, haven't read it. I'm gonna let it go, and then on the back we get something different. Prize. So Philippa Gregory writes a lot of history novels and stuff like that. So this is kind of like a history kind of fiction type thing. Now the next one I have is quite a few Philippa Gregory ones that I'm letting go. And this one is The Taming. And inside we've got the cute kind of, and it's the same on the back as well. So the this one I haven't read. I kind of used to love reading about history, but unfortunately I don't anymore. It's just not my thing. And you get like maps and stuff. There is like a normal talking video on my other channel of me going through books. The next one is The King's Curse. By Philippa Gregory, and again, I have not read this one, and I have no interest in reading it, so there's nothing kind of fancy on the inside of the covers. I literally have more in the cupboard as well. The next one is The White Queen. And I haven't read this one either. So this is kind of brand new as well. Let me see if I can find the other ones of Philippa Gregory. So all of these are Philippa Gregory as well. So we have The Lady of the Rivers, and again this is brand new and hasn't been read, so it's got a really clean spine where it hasn't been. And then we have The Red Queen and these are the covers to do with when the BBC did a TV series on it. I literally watched the TV series instead of reading the books, because if we have a TV series and the books, I'll just watch the TV series instead, just because I have piles and piles of books and there's so many books I want to review. There's that one. And then we have The Kingmaker's Daughter. tell you when these were released, because then you've got some idea how long they've been sitting in the 2013. So they've been sitting in my book pile since 2013. And then we have The White Princess by Philippa Gregory. Quite a chunky book. So those are all of the adult history fiction. We're now moving on to YA books, but I'm going to be letting go of the cat tweets. These are just basically, it's a picture book of cats. So you've got Buffy, so it's just a tiny little book of tweets from cats. So that is perfect. For any cat lover. And then the next one is a kind of Scooby-Doo, kind of free McDonald's books, and the stickers are still in there. And I picked this up from the charity shop because I absolutely love Scooby-Doo. Or I could keep this and read this on TikTok, because it's like such a cute little book. So we have to, I think I'm going to hold on to this one and do it as a little bedtime story for TikTok and Instagram. But if you want it on this channel as well, just let me know. It's just a nice little kind of read, and I shouldn't stumble upon my words. And it's got pictures in it as well. So it's like only 77 pages. So I'll keep that to one side. The next book that I got, again from a charity shop, but I'm not going to be reading because I have no interest, is Geekerella novel. I believe there's like four or five books now in the series, but sounds weird, but it's a nice addition. Oh, and we have the I've never noticed that before. So yeah, this is kind of like a romance, kind of based on Cinderella and stuff, and I'm assuming it's geeky by the title. But it was literally 20p from a charity shop, which is why I got it, so it was really an impulse buy, more than anything. So, and again, whoever had it previous, I don't think they read it because the spine is in really, really good condition and hasn't been cracked. The next trilogy I'm going to talk about is the Lauren... Oh, that one, the previous one was by Ashley Poston. The next series is Lauren... I can't pronounce the last name, so I'm just going to show you. This is the Chronicle Garden trilogy. I tried to read the first book and I got 30 pages in. It just wasn't my cup of tea. It was a little bit disturbing for me, so I'm going to be letting this trilogy go. But we have Wither, Fever, and then this one, which is the third and final book. This is in large print. Don't know how I got a large print copy. And then the second book in that trilogy is Fever. And again, these two haven't been read, so they're in pretty nice condition for the next reader. And then we have Wither, which I tried The next book, I think I may have read a section of it or half, but then never carried on. But this is the Anne Frank, The Diary of a Young Girl. I learned about her in school, watched the films, but I kind of feel like I know enough that I didn't need to carry on with the book, so I'm going to be letting that go. But we have some pictures in of Anne Frank and her family. I think it was nice that they included some pictures in there. The next one I've read, I didn't review, is How to Be Bad by E. Lockhart, Lauren and Sarah, and I can't pronounce their last name, so I'm just going to show you. And this was based on three characters, so you had, I think it's Jesse, pronounced Vix, and Mel, and they kind of all come together and they just want to have, like, they don't want to be good, they want to be bad. I read it quite fast. I read all of it, I believe. But I never reviewed it. I enjoyed it. I wouldn't want to read it again, so I'm going to be letting that one go. And how I know I've read them is because I always crack my spines on every 100 pages. The next one I read and didn't review, but the cover is absolutely stunning. This is Believe Me by Tahara Mafi. And this is like a spin-off from the series, so we've got the series here. And these are like extra short stories that have been made into books. So I've read all of these, every single one. This one came out and I was absolutely in love with the cover and was like, I have to have it because the cover is so beautiful. Every cover, in fact, is stunning. But obviously I borrowed the other ones in the library, but I'm not going to read them again, so I'm not going to buy the, you know, copies just for the covers. But yeah, this cover is absolutely stunning. And even now I look at it. But this was about Juliet's and Warren's kind of wedding and how they finally got married. So that was a nice little short story and a nice happy ending. And how they're trying to rebuild. The next book, I read the first, I've read the second, I didn't review this one. I'm not going to read them again. I got this shipped over from America because it wasn't available in the UK, but this is Nil Unlocked, and the first one was called Nil, and the third book is called Nil on Fire. So it is a trilogy. And it's about people who are having to escape an island that teenagers get stuck on. And the adults don't know where the island is. So I finally read it and finished it. So I'm going to let that go. The last two books I have 100% read and I have reviewed on my other channel is The Pageant Vampire Royals Book 1 and The Gala Book 2. I bought these from the charity shop and they are such short reads by only 191 pages. There's 8 in the series, so I am reviewing this series. But if you are interested in more about this book and this one, if you head over to the Obsidian Nook on YouTube and go into the playlist of book reviews, they'll both be in there where I go into more detail. But every book has a dress dedicated to it, because the dress is the important part of the story. And that was my book unhaul, ASMR style.